Yes, on I have.
Sorry?
Paralyzed at least.
You murdered sure. one?
Murdered one. Sir, I'm a murderer. I'm a mosquito.
How many murders you have to commit?
To become, to go on the top.
Very warm welcome to Agenda, a program through which we apprise you of the business to be conducted in Lok Sabha today. I am Amandra Bhatt. Lok Sabha is likely to see a discussion and voting on the demands for grants for railways. Besides, the Railways Appropriation Bill is likely to be introduced in the House today. In question hour today, questions relating to women's rights as well as black money stashed abroad among others are likely to be taken up. These are some of the issues we are going to focus today in Agenda. And to discuss the same, we have with us in our studios, as always, three distinguished members of Parliament. Please welcome Mr. K.S. Rao of the Congress. Welcome to Agenda, Mr. Rao. Sitting next to him is Poonam Jatt of the BJP. Welcome to Agenda, ma'am. And we're also joined by Dr. Tarun Mandal, who's an independent member of Parliament. Welcome to Agenda, Dr. Mandal.
Yeah.
Mr. Rao, I'd like to begin with you. Before we come to the agenda that is expected to be taken up today in the House, what we've been witnessing ever since the second leg of the budget session began, your first thoughts on that?
It is very unfortunate that the valuable time of the Parliament was not being used in a manner that is expected from the public of the country. And this, I don't attribute to any particular party, but all the parties must sit together and then evolve some guidelines and implement them very strictly so that the business can be done as is desired. The national issue, instead of discussing the national issues thoroughly in the interest of the people, opposition parties as well as the ruling party also are not going in the right way in sorting out these matters. So the net effect is, as a parliamentarian, we don't have satisfaction that we are doing our job well. This is my sincere opinion, no matter whether I belong to the ruling party or the opposition. And immediate steps are to be taken by all the leaders of the party to sit together. And unfortunately, I observe that every party is inclined only to get some mileage, keeping the votes in their mind, keeping the power in their mind, keeping the next elections in their mind. So any topic that is raised or discussed or the parliament is stopped, prevented from acting, is only with a view to get votes, to get a mileage, to have mileage for the party. So these tendencies ought to be discouraged, and these tendencies have to come to an end at the earliest, without which this democracy will become a laughing stock in the country.
You're talking about the opposition. You're talking about the opposition here.
Yes, certainly. Well, whether we are in opposition or they are in opposition, the opposition must be responsible opposition.
Okay.
They can criticize. There's nothing wrong in criticizing. Truth or nail, they can criticize. But not disturb the thing. I just wanted to say is, now we are in ruling, they are in opposition. So I tell the opposition must behave properly. But this applies to us also if we go to opposition.
If the roles get reversed. Poonam ji, how do you respond to the events that we've been witnessing in Lok Sabha? Mr. Rao feels shameful and he feels sad about the events turning out the way they are.
In fact, I feel sad about the situation of the country. You see in news every day there is rampant corruption, and even with the JPC report, you see the people who are have not been given a proper representation, and the JPC report is being laid in the and they are saying okay, we have to accept that. I think that is, you know, and not only Mr. Rao is saying about the opposition, what about the parties which were with them? Even they are opposing in the parliament. Even they are not like Trinamool Congress and DMK, they are opposing in the parliament. We are not responsible for that. BJP is not responsible for that. There is a chaos in the country. Everywhere there is a problem. And I think whenever the parliament runs, that's the only platform where we can oppose the government on many issues. So that is what the opposition is doing. So it's doing its job very well. That's what I think. And I don't, you know, I'm not, I don't think Mr. Rao is saying the right thing by saying ke the opposition is creating problems. Or because of votes. It's not because of the votes. You see, the country ka situation is very bad. And it is a duty of the opposition to oppose what is being wrong done.
All right, so you're saying basically you're raising legitimate issues and that you're not disrupting proceedings of the House. Dr. Mandal.
Yes, yes. See, I have always said that Parliament is not a place for bullfighting. It is a place for discussion, discourse and debates between the members, and to place their logics and arguments before the House and as well as in front of the people of the country, so that the people can understand what is the notions of each and individual party or individuals in any matter relating to the country. My point is that I am saying it has become a practice in the Parliament to place anything strongly to disrupt the House, and to, as it has become a convention, a practice, what I am watching here. See, there are. It is not true. It is a responsibility or onus on the ruling side always to run the House smoothly. But it is the responsibility of others also to see into it. And I can remember in his first speech, Mr. Admani, being the leader of the opposition that time, told to the House, we have to behave as a responsible opposition.
Right.
My point is that country is not running smoothly. There are huge scams relating to this coal mining distributions, these 2G scams. The present scenario, what is going on in West Bengal, the cheat funds, this cheating fund, which has involved more than 20,000 crores of money, and the rape of women. Probably you are entering into the empowerment of women like that, which is indiscriminately on any age, starting from the infants to higher age, this torture women of women. So these issues are so much important. If the government can take proper action through its machineries, there is no need of bringing this issue into the House. Rather, we can concentrate more on the real legislature, what is our business meant to be.
Absolutely.
But when the government is failing, its administration is failing, we cannot expect the behavior what the Delhi police did with the girls protesters. I had to accept night calls even from different areas of Delhi that police is not accepting their diaries, their FIRs regarding these torture on women, etc. That has happened time and again. So these kinds of
But Dr. Mandal, as you also said that in the past also, last year for instance in 2012, Parliament proceedings were marred by disruptions on a range of issues. First it was the 2G scam, then it was the CAG report on coal allocation, then it was FDI in retail. And as you said, precious time of Parliament is being lost. So these demands of,
don't you think that coal is precious to us? Don't you think our telecom bands are not precious
to us? But we know where it leads. So it leads to the washing out of the entire session.
This has become a notion and saying that precious time is going on. When the rulers of the country or the administrators, I am not meaning to Congress, or I am not meaning to BJP or anybody else, who are ruling the country for the people, when they are failing to save the property and the most invaluable things of the country, which is supposed to be used for the people, then these kinds of uproars will come. And definitely we have to face it within the parliament also. And I told you that it has become a practice, it has become a convention nowadays to bring anything which is involving the people's life and works.
But you know, it is becoming predictable, Mr. Rao. Session after session, we see disruption.
Yeah, the bigger parties. See, the ruling party and the opposition, the bigger opposition parties. Mr. Rao was telling that it has become a place of for catching vote banks or like that. Yes, I am also facing as a new parliamentarian that it has become a place of showing power, showing strength, and parliament has become the show of numbers only. So they have undermined the role of parliament in this capitalist system. That we cannot deny. But it is the role of the real ruling party and the main opposition bloc to intervene into it and to see that the real business of the house runs for the benefit of the people as much democratic forums we can maintain into it.
All right, we will come to the representative of the ruling party as well as the main opposition, the BJP, in just a bit. We have to take a break in the program. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Agenda. We are discussing the expected business to be taken up in Lok Sabha today. Mr. Rao, continuing with our discussion, please respond to what Dr. Mandal just said about the responsibility of the government in running the House. He believes that the onus is on the ruling party to ensure smooth functioning of Parliament.
I am not biased. What I just say is, for example, question hour is very important hour, where the opposition can tear the ruling party into pieces by putting ad hoc questions, on-the-spot questions, and the real information will come out. Suppose if there is an urgent issue to be discussed, will heavens fall if the matter is discussed after the question hour? So this, every day they say you stop the question hour, cancel the question hour and come for this. And both of them know that it will not be accepted, and they won't mind closing the entire house rather than discussing it, you know, allowing the question hour to be taken up and then discussing. Even when the ruling party commits that we will take up this issue immediately after the question hour, still the opposition says no. Because obviously the interest clearly is to attract the attention of the media, and so that it goes to the public that the opposition is very stubborn, made a lot of noise, Allah Gulla on this issue. What is this? Tell me. No, as madam says, I am not talking about the Congress party which is ruling or UPA which is ruling is a good party and then the BJP is bad or some other party is bad. Whichever party sits in the opposition is doing the same thing. As if that it concerto. I agree.
Claiming as a responsible opposition.
No, I agree. I agree. The major duty of the opposition is to find fault with the government wherever they have done a mistake. Nothing wrong in it. They can take them to task. But
not by disrupting proceedings.
Not everything. Not disturbing the house. Similarly, the ruling party also must have the patience to accept the criticism of the opposition.
That's right.
So is the government ready to discuss these issues then?
Both.
The issues that the opposition is raising.
And they don't have the tolerance to take the criticism of the opposition party. These people do not have the patience to wait for the discussions. So as my friend said, Tarun Mandal, it is a house is a place for debate, a place for legislation,
right,
place for correcting things if it is not in the interest of the people.
Track.
Not protest.
Bringing amendment. That is good. Criticism is not bad by the opposition. Ruling party will be able to do its job well only when they criticize the mistakes committed by ruling party. That mainly it is meant for it. There is nothing wrong in it.
But they are not criticizing. They are asking for the PM's resignation.
That is my point. That is my point. They are not doing constructive criticism. They are only going on raising or stopping.
I'll answer. Okay, Poonam ji, respond to that.
In fact, you know, I feel it is wrong. The people have kept the opposition for safeguarding the country's money. When, you know, scams like Pooji and Commonwealth happen, that time we saw okay, it was really important okay, we brought up a strong opposition on the parliament's floor. That's what we did. And after that only JPC was given. And because of our opposition, the government has been cornered somewhere. So that's what I feel. I don't think he's right that we are just believing shouting and disrupting the house. That is not at all our idea. It is only safeguarding the public money. When such big scams happen, daily the papers are filled with, daily some new scam is coming, the gold scam, the Commonwealth. Then, you know, somewhere the opposition has to play its role very well. The public has kept us to safeguard the interest of the country. So that's what we are doing our duty very well. And this is not our opinion, okay, by disrupting the house we'll get or we will show off as we are some strong opposition. That is not at all our idea. And even when the JPC was formed, see the working of the JPC, it is totally biased. That's what I will not say what Mr. Rao is saying is right. It was totally biased, and it's the 2G spectrum ka links have been linked to the PMO office.
Okay,
so I think it is our right to ask for the resignation of the Prime Minister's
but you know this demand for the PM's resignation, it has been dismissed by the UPA chairperson.
But naturally they will dismiss it, but as opposition we will ask for
but
it.
But where will it lead? It will lead to another wasted session then.
But why you feel it's a waste of session? Even Mr. Mandal said it's not a waste of session. Many points are being raised. You know, they might, what all things, wrong things are happening in the country, like, you know, the rape in Delhi. Even that is an issue. It's not only the resignation of PM. He has, somewhere the government has failed to safeguard the interest of the country in every manner. That's what we feel. So it's our right. We are not disturbing. We are safeguarding the interest of the country. There has to be somebody who should oppose all this wrong being done in the country.
No, my point is, why not debate these issues on
but
the
But then, you know,
the
what
house?
Will come out of the
lots
debate?
Lots of debate has been done earlier
and
also.
Even the, you know, the government has have daily, it's even its own allies are leaving the government. What is that issue, you know? Even the numbers are decreasing. yet it's like, I think it is not in majority now.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Mr. Rao, quick word from you. I'll just
tell on that, my madam, what is telling. 2G scam, for example, when the 2G scam is there, there definitely they can take the government to task. But my point here is, I was a member of the PSC also, I went into my minute details of that. When the report was given by the CAG, you know what is mentioned? The loss is 187,000 crores. And it went into public, every nook and corner of the country, that as if that the country has looted, the government has looted 1,87,000 crores. But actually, when I went into it, there is no basis to say that 1,87,000. He can comment that there are some deviations or which are to be applied, which are to be followed by the ministry or by the secretary, by etc., etc. But there is no way to calculate that loss, presumptive loss. That is, for example, because the third auction, next auction is 3G auction has come, when the money has come in 1,10,000 crores to the 3G auction, then they feel some more would have come in second 2G auction. And suppose tomorrow 4G comes in and 4G comes to 4 lakh crore, do you say that this is a scam? 3G is a scam? So, at that point of time when there is no technology, when there is no awareness in the officers' minds, in the country as a whole, because the technology is new, and they didn't know that the potentiality of the 2G is so much, the spectra can cost so much. So today, there is a good thing, gradually it comes in. Spectra's value was realized only with the 3G. Earlier, there is no value at all. Before 2G, zero. Now, realize, for example, now today we are giving hydro dams. Water is flowing. This is a natural resource, country's resource. And we are not charging anything for the people who make that. But tomorrow, gradually they realize, now they came to a stage where the builder of the dam must pay premium to the government for using the water.
Right.
Similarly, in the case with coal. Yesterday, the coal is given freely to anybody who starts a power project. But later it is realized it is a government resource, which can be auctioned. So, that means you must understand in what situation, what decision has been taken.
Okay.
Still, there can be some anomalies, there can be some mistakes of the secretary or the ministry or the government. I don't say that it is totally foolproof.
Okay.
But this is not to be taken up in a way where they are taking with a sole view of unpopularizing the government.
Okay. Okay, fine. He clarifies this and puts all the blame on the CAG for the coal and the 2G spectrum. But what about what Safai would give about the Commonwealth Games?
Right. But okay, but Poonam ji, the issue is that the parliament is getting disrupted.
I'd like to share this issue. It is basically the lack of prudent, prompt and proper actions by the government. The things are coming to such a pass in the parliament. If the government, see, in the case of JPC regarding 2G scam, ultimately the government considered to JPC. But before that, you can remember.
Now the opposition is not ready to accept the report.
That is different point. My point is, you are raising the point of installing the house. For installing JPC only, the house had to debate at least 7 to 10 days and government finally conceded to that. Before that, what government said? There is PSC, they are conducting, there is Supreme Court, the case is going on, and there is also other avenues, CBI like that. But opposition, and I personally, I can remember in the house, I told, see, the position of JPC is superior to anything and any investigating agency, because it comprises different sect of people, and parliament is the highest body. So CBI is ultimately controlled by one sort of government, and their finance is being borne by somebody.
But Dr. Mandal, is it not unfortunate that a parliamentary panel like the JPC is politically divided now?
That will be. This is not unfortunate or impossible. Point is, whenever the democratic values, the norms, the ethical things is running down, being destructed, the reflections will also come on JPC or whatever committee in the parliament. The way a committee sometimes is wanting to safeguard the government, that is also unfortunate. When Mr. Rao can tell criticism, a real kinds of criticism is welcome, that should be the voice of the government. But when the government is obstructing such kinds of real demands for the interest of the people, what will be the way out for the oppositions besides stalling the parliament? As because for that reason I was telling that we wanted JPC, ultimately the government considered JPC, but after debating 10 days in the parliament, that precious time could have been saved if the prime ministers or the UPA chairperson could realize that the oppositions of the country is not going to leave JPC.
Okay.
In the same vein, I can tell you, to blame an organization like CA&G, Comptroller Auditor General, to point a finger towards the apex court of the country is not should be a democratic gesture and a behavior of a government.
Okay, we'll have Mr. Rao respond to that.
That irritates the oppositions also to come into the floor and to disturb.
Okay, we'll have Mr. Rao respond to that and take Poonamji's views also on the same.
For this question?
Yes.
PSC is a constitutional authority. It has got all the authority to question, to find out the mistake, and it constitutes members from all the parties, same as GPC, JPC. And at one time, the BJP leader, Murali Manohar Joshi, if I remember, he said there is no need for JPC, because PSC is the chairman, BJP member is the chairman, and what more justice can be done in a JPC where congressman is the chairman of the JPC? So, it is not that it should not be there, but while I agree with him to extend, if the demand for the opposition, in spite of the fact that the PSC is a constitutional authority headed by an opposition, leading opposition party, if they still think that JPC is required, the government could have accepted for JPC without losing the 10 days time. This is my opinion.
Okay. Poonamji, currently we are witnessing this crisis in the House because the opposition is refusing to accept the draft report of the JVC on the 2G scam. But is it not unfortunate, according to you, that a House panel is politicized like this and divided in opinion like this? We saw a similar drama play out in the PSC as well.
I think, you know, we are quite justified. Because, like Mr. Rao said, PAC was quite it could have given its report, but yet we were asking for a JPC and we got it. And somewhere, because the congressman is the head of the chairman of that JPC, we think, you know, proper justification has been not done in the JPC. And even Mr. A. Raja was not called there for his questioning and all. So I feel somewhere it has lagged somewhere, and that's why we are not accepting that report. And even we are asking for the resignation of the Prime Minister, because this links to the office of the PMO. And so I think somewhere we are justified for asking for accepting that JPC report.
That's what
I feel.
Okay, well, we have to take yet another break in the program now. When we come back, we look at the question of women's right, which is likely to be taken up in question hour today. Stay with us. Welcome back to Agenda. We are discussing the expected business to be taken up in Lok Sabha today. A question relating to protection of women's rights is expected to be taken up in question hour today in the House. Dr. Mandal, on the question of women's rights, and the question particularly relates to the role of the National Commission for Women, whether or not it has adequate